Imagine opening the window of your home in the year 2100 and seeing a city that looks like it came straight out of a science fiction movie. Biotechnological skyscrapers covered in living vegetation that automatically adapts to the climate, towers that capture both solar and wind energy at the same time, and streets where there are no more regular cars, only silent aerial vehicles gliding above the roads. On the horizon, drones deliver packages in just a few minutes, and robots roam everywhere, taking care of cleaning, security, and even gardening. But it's not just about technology. These cities are intelligent in the deepest sense. Every traffic light, every lamp, and every transportation system is connected to a central artificial intelligence network that adjusts everything in real time, ensuring the perfect flow of people and resources. On the horizon, drones deliver packages in just a few minutes, and robots roam everywhere, taking care of cleaning, security, and even gardening. But it's not just about technology. These cities are intelligent in the deepest sense. Every traffic light, every lamp, and every transportation system is connected to a central artificial intelligence network that adjusts everything in real time, ensuring the perfect flow of people and resources. This is just the first impression of the cities of the future. But as we will see, this transformation goes far beyond aesthetics. It promises to radically change the way we live, work, and even interact with one another. In 2100, urban infrastructure will be practically invisible to residents, not because it will cease to exist, but because it will operate so automatically that you won't even notice it. Streets will be equipped with smart sensors that constantly monitor the flow of pedestrians, vehicles, and drones, reorganizing routes in real time to avoid congestion and collisions. Bridges, tunnels, and highways will have autonomous maintenance systems with specialized robots capable of detecting and repairing damage before it causes any problems. Buildings, in turn, will be true living entities. Modular structures will allow a skyscraper to change its shape and function according to the city's needs. Today, it may be a shopping center, tomorrow, a residential complex. Self-healing materials will make cracks and wear repair themselves, extending the lifespan of structures for centuries. Even the supply of water and energy will be automatic. Drinking water will be produced and purified within the city itself through advanced desalination and recycling systems. Energy will come from integrated renewable sources, transparent solar panels on windows, hidden wind turbines on rooftops, and even sidewalks that generate electricity from the weight of people's footsteps. This total automation will free residents from bureaucratic or maintenance tasks, allowing them to focus their time on leisure, innovation, and social interaction. However, this dependence on autonomous systems also raises an important question: who controls the city, after all? And what happens if this central intelligence fails? By the year 2100, buildings will no longer be static blocks of concrete and steel. They will become living organisms designed to interact and adapt to the environment. Biotechnological buildings will be made of materials grown in laboratories, such as biosmint and genetically modified wood, capable of growing, self-regenerating, and even changing color to regulate internal temperature. These structures will have a photosynthetic skin, capturing sunlight to generate energy while purify the air. External walls will be able to open or close like petals, adapting to sunlight, rain, or wind, ensuring thermal comfort without excessive energy consumption. Instead of air conditioning, an intelligent natural ventilation system will make the air circulate as if the building were breathing. The design will be radically different from what we know today. Straight, rigid lines will give way to organic curves inspired by leaves, shells, and cellular structures. Each building will be unique, growing, and transforming over time according to the needs of the community it houses. Buildings will also have integrated vertical farming systems, producing fruits, vegetables, and even lab-grown proteins for residents. As a result, the city will not depend as much on food transportation, reducing environmental impact. But this symbiosis between architecture and biotechnology raises an intriguing question. If buildings are living organisms, could they develop some kind of behavior? And, even more intriguingly, could we talk to them? In 2100, the sight of streets packed with cars and blaring horns will be just a distant memory. Cities will have almost completely shifted to urban air transport systems, an integrated set of vertical electric aircraft, passenger drones, and even autonomous flying capsules. These vehicles will be silent, fast, and guided by artificial intelligence, flying along pre-programmed three-dimensional routes to avoid collisions and optimize traffic flow. Imagine ordering transport through your phone and, within seconds, a transparent, aerodynamic capsule lands on your building's balcony, ready to take you directly to your destination without stops or congestion. Air mobility stations will replace bus terminals and subway stations, functioning as large hubs suspended in the sky, connected by networks of landing pads and charging docks. Some of these platforms will float over rivers or coastal areas, making use of airspace and reducing impact on the ground. Air transport will also be crucial for emergencies. Flying ambulances will arrive within minutes anywhere in the city, and rescue teams will access areas isolated by natural disasters without depending on roads. And it's not just about functionality. Urban air travel will be designed to be memorable. Cabins with panoramic glass, augmented reality showing tourist spots, and even nighttime routes with lights painting the sky as if they were artificial constellations. But one question arises. If the airspace of cities becomes as busy as today's streets, could the skies end up congested too? By 2100, cities will not only be smart and technological, they will be resilient. Faced with a century marked by extreme weather events, rising sea levels, and drastic ecosystem changes, urban architecture and infrastructure will have adapted to protect and sustain human life in any condition. In coastal regions, we will see massive transparent domes protecting entire neighborhoods from storms and flooding. These domes will be made of ultra-resistant, self-repairing materials capable of filtering air, controlling temperature, and even generating energy from wind and waves. Floating cities will also become a reality, with ocean-anchored housing platforms equipped with integrated farming and desalination systems. In desert areas, buildings will be designed to capture moisture from the air and produce drinking water. Photovoltaic roofs and reflective surfaces will keep interiors comfortable even under extreme heat. Some cities will even adopt underground systems to escape the heat, creating true worlds beneath the surface. Vegetation will be a key part of this adaptation. Green corridors and vertical gardens will act as natural temperature regulators and air purifiers. Specialized artificial intelligences will monitor every inch of the city, adjusting irrigation, ventilation, and pollutant filtration according to the day's conditions. These changes will not just be about comfort, but survival. However, with so much control over climate and the urban environment, a new question will arise. Are we creating perfect cities or isolated bubbles from natural reality? As futuristic as they may seem, the cities of 2100 will not just be a technological spectacle, they will deeply shape how we relate, work, and perceive the world. With automation taking over virtually all operational tasks, citizens will have more free time, but they will also face a challenge: what to do with it? The concept of work will radically change. Many professions we know today will disappear, replaced by creative, research-oriented, or socially focused activities. The urban space itself will be designed to encourage encounters, socializing, and collaboration. Suspended squares, panoramic cafes, and virtual reality areas will allow people from different parts of the planet to meet as if they were side by side. Education will be continuous and immersive. Physical schools will give way to hybrid learning centers where virtual classrooms and hands-on experiences coexist. Children will be able to travel to ancient Rome or the surface of Mars without leaving the city, thanks to holograms and hyper-realistic simulations. Physical and mental well-being will also be a priority. Sensors spread throughout the city will monitor citizens' vital signs and stress levels, offering personalized recommendations and even sending assistance drones in cases of medical or emotional emergencies. But such deep integration between city and individual raises an inevitable reflection: to what extent will we have control over our own lives? Will we be living in an urban paradise or in a reality carefully designed for us? The future of the cities of 2100 is bright, but like every great transformation, it will come with choices that will define who we truly are in this new world.